Okay, today we're dehydrating fresh tomatoes. You want to pick ripe tomatoes, not overripe. Cut off any blemishes on them. And when you get to the little ends, these don't dehydrate as quick. So we cut that little skin off that bottom part to help it dehydrate. Otherwise, they take forever. And we're cutting these quite thick, about like that. I have seen before where they, if you do them too thin, they're going to dehydrate down to nothing and you're not going to have much left to even take off the screen. And I use these little, herb screens that came with my dehydrator. It helps you to get the final dried tomatoes off of the screens much easier. So we're doing a whole bunch of tomatoes. You want them about this far apart. And my husband suggested blotting them, which I think is a great idea, with some paper towels to get some of the juice off of them to help get going on the dehydrating. I'm going to start these at 160 degrees for probably the first hour or two, just to get them going, get them dried out, and then put them down to probably 145 or 50. Tomatoes take 12 to 14 hours. I have a note that last time we did them, it was hot and humid. And that makes a difference, too. If you got dry weather, they'll dry quicker. It was hot and humid, and it took 14 hours. So I'll show you these when they're done. And that's about how thick he's doing them. Right there. You can see the thickness when I trim this. I'm using a Nesco professional dehydrator that I got on Amazon. I'll have to tell you the model later. I'm not sure what it is. Okay. My Nesco dehydrator, I thought I got it on Amazon. I didn't. It's got a Walmart receipt with it. I think I priced it everywhere. It's a professional Nesco. Number FD75PR. I got good reviews on this. The price was good. I got mine on Walmart.com for $59.98 plus tax. Was $64.78 with tax. And I've been real happy with it so far. I very seldom use those lower settings on it, though. Because I'm one that wants to get stuff done quick. I don't want to wait days to get it done. So. But your lower temperatures would be good for herbs and things like that. Okay, I've got this started at 160 degrees. I'm going to let it go for at least an hour or two on that and then turn it down. Then I'll turn it to 145. These trays like this, not the trays, but these little, what do you call these? These screens. You have to buy separately. So, just wanted to let you know that. Okay, it's been 9 hours now, and I'm checking these. They're getting there, but they still feel really moist. See, they're just not ready yet. Usually it takes about 12 to 14 hours. But this is 9 hours. I'll wait another probably hour or two and check them again. Okay, it's 12 hours later. And see how they look dry and they're like leather. They're still warm, so that's how they should look right there. Dry and leathery. That one's crisp. But the big ones should be dry and leathery. Perfect. I'm going to put these in Ziplocs because it's late tonight and tomorrow I'm going to put them in vacuum seal bags. So that's our tomatoes. 12 hours later, we did them 3 hours on 160 and the rest of the time on 145. All of those trays came out to this much. Look how beautiful. I'm putting it in a Ziploc till tomorrow and then I'm going to put them in vacuum seal bags. And the little tomatoes, the tiny ones, are still a little moist. I've got one layer of them. I'm going to let those go for another probably half hour. Then I'll add them to this.